Hello, I'm Tabitha, the product manager for Turnitin. Today I'm going to take you through voice comments. So if I'm an instructor looking at GradeMark and I want to leave a voice comment for my student's paper, I can go to the general comments panel and I'll see the new voice comments section. If I want to begin recording, I just click on this microphone and I just agree to the flash player settings that appear. Close that. And then I'll see that my recording has begun because it says recording at the top, and I can see the blue audio level bar is moving in time with me talking, so it is picking up my sound. I can scroll through the paper, make comments on the things that I see as I go along. I can go over to my rubric. The recording will continue in the background. I can comment on the things I see in my rubric. I can go back to my general comments. I can see it's still recording. If I want to pause to look at something and think about it, I just click pause. It's paused. It's not picking up what I'm saying right now. And I can think about what I want to say. When I know, I just click to resume, and my recording picks back up just where it was. I don't necessarily want to start typing on the paper because, of course, the recorder will pick up the clickety-click, and that's what my students will hear. I also don't want to leave GradeMark, so if I try to leave and go to originality, it's going to warn me that my comment hasn't been saved. Of course, it is still saved. It is still recording in the background. I can stay here, or I can leave and get rid of my comment altogether. But I'm just going to stay. When I'm done recording, I just click stop, and that will finish my recording. So here I can play it back, see if I like it. If I do like it, I can choose to save it. If I don't like it, I can discard it and start all over again. I am going to save this one. My comment right now is 54 seconds long. I'm on 3 in the playback. I can be 3 minutes long, but 54 seconds is enough for me. I'm just going to click save. It's going to prepare to save, it's going to save, and then it's going to give me the player. With the player, I can play the recording. I can listen to it as my students will hear it. And I can skip around in it. So I can click play, I can shuffle around, move to different parts, hear it, pause. If I now decide I don't like it, I can still throw it away, I can discard it, come back, start again. Students will see this player. They won't see the discard button. That's all we have for voice comments. I hope you enjoy using them. Thank you for watching the video.